this is by far the best pump in the market. 95% of boats sailing today have grossly inadequate pumps. The standard installation is 2 10 GPM gallons per minute pumps, one mounted on deck, one mounted below decks. That is totally inadequate if the boat springs a leak. As is illustrated by the story of Outer Limits and also Isle Air, two contrasting stories. Outer Limits hit something 350 miles east of Bermuda. They started leaking. They connected up an emergency electrical pump, which kept everything under control until it burned out. Once the pump burned out, they got to work with their two GPM pumps. They decided they could not keep ahead of the leaking, hit the panic button, hit the air perb. Coast Guard organized the pickup from a freighter. They abandoned the boat. But the boat continued to float for 48 hours before the transmitter on the tracker went off. With no one on board, it floated for 48 hours before it finally sank. In contrast to that, in 1995, Isle Air was 400 miles west of the Azores, hove to in a gale, when we suddenly discovered we were leaking. This had us completely surprised because we'd just gone through a major refit rebuild. We started pulling up floorboards, pulling up gear, and we traced the leak all the way up to the stem, and it was pissing on through at the stem at a fair rate. But with one Edson pump like this, 30 gallons per minute, we sucked the bilge dry with no trouble at all. We then discovered that if someone pumped for 10 minutes out of every 30, they would keep the bilge right down to nothing. So one crew member would sit and read for 20 minutes and then pump for 10. That's 300 gallons every 10 minutes, 600 gallons an hour. We continued to do that for 48 hours until we got to the Azores and we discovered it was a broken stem bolt in an area of the boat we had never worked on during the refit. If we had not had an Edson pump, Isle Air certainly would have gone glug, 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 and we would have had to abandon her. But going offshore, or even coastal cruising when you're going offshore for a day or so, it's absolutely essential you have on board a 30 GPM pump, 30 gallons per minute. The ocean racing rules require one pump. They can be operated from on deck with all the hatches closed, another below deck. But the handle can be taken off. You just open up this little catch, take the handle off, and the cockpit side is absolutely clean. There's nothing just sticking out to catch on anything. When you want to pump, you just take the handle, shove it on there, and you're ready to go. So the handle is at waist level. Well, having the long handle means you're not bending over at all. If you have a short handle, first of all, you need more leverage to pump, and second of all, you're bending over. And if you're bending over, it gets hard pumping after about 10 or 15 minutes. The good thing about this mounting is the pump is below decks, but the pump handle is on deck. You can pump it with all hatches closed. This pump I'm on now is the gold plater, a beautiful, big, wonderful bronze pump. It will probably last for 100 years. It's also available in galvanized iron and also available in aluminum. Now, if you don't have a big Edson permanently mounted and you have two of those little tiny pumps that are totally useless, the other solution is to buy an Edson mounted on a board with two long hoses. So in an emergency, you can throw one hose in the bilge, one hose overside, and then pump away. So you're getting ready to go to sea and you haven't got time to mount a proper Edson below decks. So what do? You contact Edson and buy one of their Edson pumps on board, two long hoses, so you can put one hose down below decks into the bilge, the other overside, and you hope to hell you don't need it. But if you suddenly start leaking like a sieve, standing on the board, you can pump 30 gallons a minute, and that's a hell of a lot of water. The one thing you should do with the Edson pump, when it comes on the board, turn it over and get some indoor-outdoor carpeting and tack the indoor-outdoor carpeting on the bottom of the board with copper tacks. Then when you put it down on a slippery fiberglass deck, the board will not slide around. Also, if you're bounding it yourself, don't worry about a good piece of mahogany plywood. Go out and find a piece of good old fir plywood. Bolt it down to that. Then your feet won't slip on it. You've got a good pump. It will stay in one place where you stand on it and pump.
Don, tell me how Edson came up with the idea to mount that big old pump on a board.
Well, back in the 60s, I was doing a lot of deliveries between the States and the Caribbean, or the Caribbean and the States. And I ran into a boat that I didn't like the pump system. I figured it was grossly inadequate. So I called up Will Keane's father and said, send me down one of your aluminum Edson pumps with two lengths of hose, and gave him the length of hose. And then about 6 months later, I did another delivery, and I did the same thing. And then a month or so after that, I had another delivery, again, Rottenville's pumps, and I called him up and got him to send me another one. And at this point, he said, what the hell are you doing with all these bilge pumps? Throwing them overside and abandoning them, or what? And I said, no, I'm delivering boats that have rotten bilge pumping systems. I take your pump and I mount it on a board, connect up the two hoses, and it's all set and ready to go if I have to pump. And I just hope to hell I don't need the pump, but I got the pump if I need it. Well, the next year, the Edson catalog had a pump mounted on a board with two lengths of hoses on it, an emergency bilge pump. That's where it came from, back in the 60s. The Edson pump is the number one pump in the world. One of the biggest and most important things is it has a 2.5-inch intake, 2.5-inch discharge, and you don't need a bilge strainer. You just put two small bolts through the intake pipe, forming an X to keep big things out. The small garbage gets sucked right through the pump and right overside, so you don't have trouble with having to clear scum boxes. The Edson pump is first, there is no second.
Now this thing here, this is the detentioner, or is that another way of looking at that?
That's actually a 2-3, and this is steering.
Yep. Okay, the sailing thing.